Alright, everybody, welcome back for round two with Grix's Control. We're on the draw here with a six card. Our opponent going to a six card hand, excuse me. We're on seven cards. We have a one lander with each of our blue cantrips, a Terminate, a Cryptic, and a Cooldowns command. I think I'm going to keep this hand. It's not great, but not a hand that I'm willing to mulligan, especially when my opponent's mulliganing, and I've got the ability to remove some creatures in the mid game. We can cantrip ourselves into some lands, and we've got a very good. Turn 5 Ancestral here. Resolving. We played a Brushland and passed. So this is either Tron, Eldrazi, or Boggles. I think I'm just going to follow up with the line here and spend this Ancestral. If it's Eldrazi, we're going to need to play for the super late game here. Opponent bottom played a second Brushland. More Ancestrals. Alright, well, no Seer Visions now. Alright, well, kind of want this Bolt. Yeah, I'm going to top the Bolt as a safety precaution, and I'll top this Water Grid. I'm playing a second land. Not great, but definitely not the worst thing ever. Alright, so they are Eldrazos. Spellskite's really good against my hand. Alright, so I think the plan here is we're going to need a Thought Scout with the Lightning Bolt off the top of our library, because you certainly cannot afford to draw that here. I'm gonna. Oh boy. We also might want to get this Terminate out of our hand just in case it isn't an old Thought Not Seer. Because we need it in the graveyard to Snapcaster back. This is turn 3, so in 2 more turns we get our other Ancestral off. Alright, I think I'm gonna shock myself with this Watery Grave. And I'm going to spend another Ancestral and pass. If our Terminate gets taken, so be it. We're not in a great spot. Product of keeping a hand like this. Alright, our opponent has neither a land nor a play. So our opponent's hand is just all expensive nonsense. And we found a land. That was great. Okay, so now we have an assembly line of lands coming here. We just need to sort of play spells. So I'm going to pass here to our opponent. Next turn, note, we're going to currently draw up to 10 cards. Opponent's on 6 cards. Let's go ahead and shatter and make them discard. So this way, Spellskite's out of our way. We have an Ancestral coming off. We'll go up to 9 cards on our turn. So maybe start like a Worldbreaker or some nonsense. Oh, Path to Exile. Yeah, the card's not great in this matchup for them. Alright, let's draw some cards. Maybe we'll see it countered or something. Alright, let's play. Kind of want to leave up this Ancestral Visions. Or, sorry, this Cryptic Command and not suspend this Ancestral Visions because we got another one coming off in 2 turns. What will we discard to hand size in that event? I guess the Steam Vents. What is Serum Visions? Yeah, let's just discard the Steam Vents. It's a world where we grind our opponent so hard that we're going to want to suspend another Ancestral. Eldrazi Skyspawner. That's fine. So with this, I'm going to go ahead and shock the little guy, the Scion token, so they don't have the mana. I'm going to cause them to discard a card. Because my opponent's constrained on mana here, and a 2-1 flyer is not going to end up killing me with my current hand. Wow, they discarded a Thought Not Seer. That's crazy. Crazy. And use this Delta to fetch a swamp. Serum Visions. Tassigar and Snapcaster Rage. Yeah, these are great cards. Alright, let's leave up our Cryptic. We have another Ancestral coming off next turn, so we'll drop to 10 cards. So it is very possible at the end of our opponent's turn here, we'll just fire off a Terminate anyways if they don't play anything. Ancient Stirrings. Yeah, I think it's worth it countering it just to keep our opponent stuck on lands. Alright, so we dropped 10 cards here. Not some great ones there. And that's also a bad card, so we can just discard that one to hand size. So what I want to do here is we're going to want to suspend this Ancestral Visions, play this Tasigur, exiling Visions, Visions, Thought Scour, Serum, Serum. And let's just start fetching in a water grave tapped. Alright, so that guy's getting pathed also. That's fine by me. Let's go get 1, 2, 3, 4. So if you're playing at a water grave with that, we can just get a basic mountain. Another Ancient Strings. It's fine. If it gets a temple, that could be annoying, but it's not the end of the world. And so teeth, sure. Alright, fetch down to 10. Got a bunch of nonsense in our hand. Alright, more nonsense. So now we have Snapcaster, Cryptic Up, and the ability to leave up Terminate. So that's what we'll do this turn. Of note, this game could actually get kind of interesting if our opponent managed to draw Cavern of Souls and just have three Reality Smashers in their hand. But we have so many useless cards to discard that I don't think that's going to be the case. Alright, we'll terminate this now. It's nice because the Terminate actually just sits in the graveyard for us for a while. And let's Snapcaster Crypt Command that. Opponent's got 3 cards left. So we should just counter draw this. Pull this out, sorry. So we have 2 more turns on our copy of Ancestral Visions over there. Let's go ahead and mill ourselves this Thought Scour in case we find another Cryptic Command. We do not. Let's fetch up our last island, preserve our life total ever so slightly. So that way we can Serum Visions. That's a Snapcaster. Probably don't need our third Tasker. Let's terminate, still fine. We'll still keep that. Let's play the Tasigur, Exile, Spell Snare, Lightning Bolt, and we can move away. Whatever, too late. Don't care to undo it. And let's attack with the Snapcaster Mage. Got a bunch of Kolaghan's Command action over here too. So an opponent does start playing spells, or they won't. All right. Well, that was getting to the spot where I was gonna put the Engineered Explosives on 0, so when our opponent played a Drone Rip Hope, we could kill all of their Scions. Alright, so against Eldrazi, our main idea here is try to fight them on their mana, but also be willing to adapt and fight their creatures. So, they don't really play 2 mana plays in their deck, so our Spell Snares are particularly poor. And because they're playing on such diverse mana cost and playing such large mana cost, things are Engineered Explosives is also going to be quite poor. So there's going to be 3 cards we cut for sure. Games tend to go long, Ancestral Visions is pretty fantastic, so are the rest of our blue cantrips. The Lightning Bolts are in a weird spot where they can be good when they draw like their Eldrazi Displacer hands and their Noble Hierarch slash Birds of Paradise. You can use it to blow up all of those. But in all, the card's pretty weak, but it's a card that I tend to leave in. The Counter Skulls are particularly poor also. We're going to move them into the cut section. Not you, Terminate. You're probably the best card that we actually have in this matchup. Alright, so we have 4 fantastic cards and 5 not so fantastic cards. So the 5th one that I tend to bring in is usually a copy of Anger of the Gods. So Anger of the Gods can help fight their mana reshapers, Eldrazi Displacers, and their green mana accelerators, as well as get you out of some tricky spots where you can pair Anger with other cards to fight things like Worldbreaker, for example. And now, since they're playing the Eldrazi Sky Spawner in their list, you actually have some reasonable threats that Anger can hit. Excuse me. Alright, so we're going to sleeve up this 64, game number 2. Let's get in there and battle. If more people start going to lists with Eldrazi Sky Spawners and maybe a full set of nobles, full set of birds, to the point where they had a bunch of things that Azus Attacaster can hit, I could see Azus Attacaster being better than the Anger. Alright, this hand has lands and spells. The spells are not very good and the lands are fine, but I'm going to keep it. Turn 1 temple. Jeez, that's aggressive. Alright, well, given that, I'm going to go ahead and fetch a watery grave off of my Scalding Tarn and hopefully try to scry to the top of our deck with the Searing Visions A Terminate. Don't want either of these. Let's get these out of here. It's a pretty poor draw. Ancient Stirrings. Let's see what our opponent finds. Thought Knot Seer, Reality Smasher, the two pretty scary ones. Something our opponent could play. I mean, of course not this turn, because they just have a temple out. I mean, they can only really play, like, Chalice or Relic of Regenitus. I mean, you could find Drowner of Hope. That's also a pretty scary card. Or Lance. Not good. Not good at all. When you keep a very slow, very clunky hand like this, this is the last sort of cards you want to draw. Alright, I'm just going to fetch here and get more lands out of my deck, even though I bought him two cards there. Probably not a good thing to shuffle back in. My opponent doesn't have anything. Are they just Reality Smasher flooded? What in the world is going on over there? Alright, let's get ourselves Steam Vents. Then to play tapped, we'll Thought Scour ourselves. Okay, we got a Terminate into our yard, so we find a Snapcaster Mage, we can start doing a little bit of work here. Alright, found ourselves a Tassiger. That can pair up with Kolaghan's Command to fight off the threat of a Reality Smasher by shocking it. I don't love doing that, but it's a play we can certainly make. We have one more Water Grave in our deck we could fetch tapped here. Trying to think of what's better. We definitely want to leave in the Terminate. I guess we could exile everything else. Yeah, let's just go ahead and do that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But tapping the Stevens, it's better. Might need the extra card later. And we have another island in our hand, so we should get a Blood Crypt out there. This is likely to get pathed. Oh, it's getting dismembered. Okay, fair enough, fair enough. Opponent probably has to have a land here, based on the way this game has gone. There it is. Alright, Reality Smasher number 1. So now we can bolt Kolaghan's Command this. The current plan is I'm going to hold up Cryptic for this turn to try to counter and bounce and then discard probably Spoluda Delta because I don't want to take another point. When my opponent doesn't find a Cavern of Souls. Ooh, Gavany Township, that's really bad. Alright, we're going to go to 6. Ugh, that's brutal. I have never seen Gavany Township in this deck before. Guess I could have played around that better. Wow, it's brutal. Well, what we can do is we can force them to discard a card and get back our Tassiger for now. So let's return target creature, make them discard. Current plan here being that probably going to have to Cryptic Tap their team. Just discard another temple. Now I'm trying to figure out what's going on over there. I'm just going to place Water Gear tapped. Plan on tapping my opponent's team and drawing a card. Could have gotten our opponent if we had just waited, potentially. Alright, let's tap their team and draw a card. They fetch up a Stubborn Anel here, that is fine. We are dead. I'm fine with being dead. Spell. Okay, that's a good one to know about. Spell is not a normal card we see, but now that I know they have Dispel instead of Stubborn Anel, it's good to know about. Gavinny Township and Dispel. Interesting cards. So, I'd want to change anything given that information. I don't think that we do. I think everything we have here makes a bit more sense than everything up here on our sideboard. So let's go ahead and run it back, just play a little bit better. Maybe keep a better hand, mulligan to a better hand. Potentially play around Gavinny Township. Alright, let's be on the play. We have a Terminate, a Kolaghan's Command, and a Serum Visions. This is a keeper. Gonna want to fetch our second Water Grave with this Scalding Tarn, as that'll get us to two black sources for Damnation. Our opponent's Scry to the top. Right, let's get our Water Grave, for 17, use our Serum. Ancestral and Polluted Delta. Well, we'll take the Ancestral Visions. Definitely don't want Polluted Delta. Second island, pretty bad draw. Can't always get Jawan, unfortunately. So let's suspend the visions, play a tap steam vents, send it back to our opponent. Alright, so we do have the temple. Oh, there's a displacer or a spawner, yep. Alright, I'm gonna plan to leave up this Terminate here. Given that we drew Cryptic, we have two islands in our hand. It's unfortunate we drew Cryptic this turn. It's likely to get Thought Not Seared out of our hand. It gets Reality Smashered. Alright, so my plan here is I'm playing this island because there are some percentage of hands or games that I'm going to want to shock this Scion and make my opponent discard a card here. And that's going to come from the times exactly like this where they're passing. So I'm going to make them discard and I'm going to kill this silly Scion. Ancestral Vision's got two more turns to go. Okay, we discarded a Noble rather than playing it. It's good to know about. Ooh, and we drew the Damnation. That is a quality draw. Right, still going to play this island. Look to counter and draw something. Hold on to 12 here. I think given this tap point, I do want to just terminate my opponent's creature. Try to play as safe as possible with my life total at this point. And effective with my mana. So I do have this Ancestral coming to me next turn. Still have Cryptic up. Drew another Terminate, which is quite lucky. Opponent's just flooded all beyond eternity over there. We're going to drop to 7 cards here unless they have like a negate or something. They do not. It's pretty good for us. Get Creeping Tar Pit out there so we can try to get to the point where we're holding up Cryptic and Terminate. Opponent chose not to fetch there, if that's interesting. Or an Ancient Stirring, so the card we fear going to fight around. I don't think I want to. I think I'd rather let them get their crazy giant monster and just try to fight the crazy giant monsters. Runner of Hope. That is not the crazy giant monster I usually want to fight against. Let's try Thought Scouring ourselves, see what we can find. Did not find any creatures, but we can Thought Scour ourselves again. Still didn't find any of our creatures. They're evading us. They're hiding. I don't think there's any use here in just Kolaghan's commanding our opponents. I'm just going to untap and draw. Find a Snapcaster Mage the hard way. Of note, we did not mill over any of our red fetchable lands, which is nice. We don't want to lose those. We don't have to. Our opponent is too timid to run out into possible Cryptic Command mana, which is very, very noticeable of them. I think here what I'm going to do is actually Cryptic Command and bounce one of their lands to try to gain tempo. Yep, that's what I'm going to do. Not going to crack my Delta first, because I'd actually rather... I don't want to crack my Delta first, because I'd actually rather draw more lands here, because I'm currently on 7. Drawing an 8th land is actually pretty good in the spot. I drew a full mana range. That's pretty awesome, actually. Alright, let's get our Blood Crypt. Drew that land that we were talking about. That's awesome also. So, knowing that they can only produce 6 mana next turn, let's first off just attack with Snappy. And run out Fulminator. I'm going to let them play their temple. I'm going to look to blow up their temple and counterbalance their spell they play this turn. Okay, so they're trying to hide their temple. So given they're trying to hide their temple, let's blow up the Hallowed Fountain. And let's cause them to discard a card and we'll return our little buddy, the Fulminator Mage. We should probably counter this. Yep. Then let's fetch. Draw a Bolt. Alright, let's attack up on down 15 here. Still in a really good spot. Runner of Hope. So let's counter and could return our Snapcaster Mage. Then Thought Scour. That just puts 2 more cards in our graveyard because we don't have 9 lands. We can't pick up our Snapcaster and Kolaghan's Command to make them discarding it back our Fulminator again. So what we could do here is counter, pick up Snapcaster, bolt them, snap bolt them. Like that. That actually puts them on a pretty tough clock. Yeah, let's do that. So let's bolt them. Oh. No, our opponent just conceded. Alright, so our opponent must have just been on a lot of nothing, I guess. You're gonna probably draw pretty decently over the next couple of turns, which Probably would have ended the game with the help of a little creeping tar pit beatdown. So we're 2-1 now in this modern.